continuously inspire you tirelessly, how your mother will wake you up tirelessly. Indian mothers will nag you and wake you up. They will make sure you get up in time and go to school every day. That's the beauty of Indian mothers. My satsang is like Indian mother, waking you up every day, reminding you about the absolute every day, awakening you every day.
I welcome you all with my love and respect. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, living and practicing Hindus, de facto Kailashians. All the Mantreshwaras, Vidyeshwaras, Ganeshwaras, లోకేశ్వర శస్త్రేశ్వర డిప్లొమాట్స్ ఈ డిప్లొమాట్స్ సిటిజన్స్ కన్సులేట్ జనరల్స్ సపోర్టర్స్ ఎవ్రీ వన్ సిట్టింగ్ విత్ అస్ ఆల్ ఓవర్ ద వరల్డ్ పరమశివోహం సీజన్ 14 పార్టిసిపెంట్స్ అండ్ పరమశివ గణాస్ ఐ వెల్కమ్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ యూ విత్ మై లవ్ అండ్ బ్లెస్సింగ్స్ Paramashiva's message directly from Sri Kailasa. Listen. Your body represents your lifestyle. Your body represents your inner space. Your body ultimately represents the kind of the consciousness you carry. Your body ultimately represents the quality of the consciousness you carry. So, listen intensely. I am teaching you now the science of building you, manifesting you, like how from mud the pot is made, same way I'll teach you the science of using consciousness and manifest your life. Simple three instruction. Listen, I'll explain the logic, science behind the instructions next. First, listen. The root chakra, Mooladhara, the lust centric, lust energy centric chakra. Second, Swatishtana, the spleen chakra, fear centric. Third, Manipuraga, navel chakra, food and ori centric. Now, listen intensely. In the lust center, there is no difference between your visualization and actual action. The actual actions impact and your visualizations impact on your life. If you see, the actual actions of your lust may have only the legal implications externally. Other than the legal implication, whether it's a legitimate wife or illegitimate or gay or lesbian, other than the legal, socio-legal component of the sexual act, the act or the mind, mental action, please understand, simple words, very raw, your fantasy, your pornography, your masturbation, all this and actual sexual act, this too, if you see, all the mind related sexual actions, body related actions, other than the legal implication, there is no two difference, there is no second difference on the consciousness between these two. Let me put it more and more straight, because I am talking to the large open audience My words need to be very clearly spelled out. That is why step by step I am spelling it out and using long sentences. Listen. Consciously, your visualizations about sex, pornography, masturbation, all these has the same effect as physical act. And I am not going to say physical act is good, bad, right, wrong. If this is same, then why not go for physical act? All those logic I am not going to analyze. I am going to reveal some of the most important truths for your enlightenment. Let me stop from the angle of attending to this whole issue only from the angle of enlightenment. Listen. Listen sincerely. Let me give you some of the conclusions. Let me give you some of the conclusions so you will understand the logic. First, mentally digesting all the fantasies of sex, body pleasures, completes your being, liberates you from undersexed or oversexed bondage ideas. Man or woman, person who always equates sexual pleasure to the sexual act feels either undersexed or oversexed, feels all the time others are oversexed and they are undersexed. Too much of complicated relationship with sex leads to complicated relationship with the body, leads to complicated, very frustrated relationship with the thinking itself. Please understand, this is two important thing you need to know. Now listen, listen intensely. You need to know the conclusion I wanted to give, and powerful cognitions you need to carry, both. The conclusion I wanted to give, listen carefully. Your conscious expression, manifestation of lust, sex, sexual acts, fantasies, pornographic manifestations, your wild perversions, everything. If you sit and chew them consciously, not mentally. There is a difference between mentally and consciously. If you chew sexual fantasies mentally, you will be obsessed and all the actions related to sex will be like a compulsion, forced. There will not be any conscious involvement, freedom or participation. More like a, you have to sneeze. Listen carefully. Mind binds, consciousness liberates. Formula. Basic sutra. Mana is bandha. Chit is moksha. mind is bondage. Anything done mentally leads to obsession and obsessive compulsive behavior. Consciously, when you engage with your fantasies, desires, sex related right, wrong, good, bad, socially accepted, legitimate or perversion, anything. If you can consciously use your visualization and get involved, you will be liberated without need for the physical act from the feeling of undersexed or oversexed, denied or exploited. All the incompletions, frustrations related to sex. All human beings feel, whether they are having legitimate marriage relationship or outside marriage relationships, whatever may be, irrespective of age, gender, orientations, choices, everybody feels either undersexed or oversexed, either deprived or exploited. It's like a cycle. The fundamental root cause is sex remains as obsession, compulsion. The act does not have liberating consequence, fulfilling consequence. It may be tiring, releasing, letting you rest, but not fulfilling. Please understand, I'm getting into the deepest important formula for power manifestation. If you understand what I am talking today, not only you will be liberated from thousands of problems, you will start manifesting powers. So I want all of you to watch this satsang 3-4 times, because many statements I am making, individually they won't make sense. Only if you listen step by step, they will make sense. First, the root chakra, lust centric energy center, Mooladhara chakra. Impact of sex on your consciousness is same whether it is physical or mental or visual or imagination or fantasizing. Only socio-political legal impacts are different, but inside the impact is same whether it is an action or imagination. So understand the deeper revelations. If you intensely, consciously involve with your visualizations, fantasies, without labeling them as legitimate, illegitimate, socially accepted, romance or perversion, and just see consciously and start digesting them, you will experience absolute liberation. There will not be any need for external act. If there is a external act, it will be more like a gracing, not compulsion. Second, the Swadhisthana Chakra, fear centric. If you sit and consciously involve intensely in all your fears and the root cause of fears and insecurities, you will be completely free from all fears, and the kind of the boldness, courage you will manifest. See, at one point you will reach the source of your fears, you will feel, oh, everything is over. From this moment, whatever way life happens is a bonus. That's all what can be done. When that shift happens to you, that is the moment Yama, Kala is giving you the blessing of not taking life for granted and liberating you from all the fear-centric behavioral patterns. See, at one point in my life, I reached, everything is over. Now, if I am alive from next moment, whatever way I may exist is a blessing, bonus. Understand? Listen to this very carefully. This realization is the boon from Yama, Kala. Decision not to hang on to our fantasies about life and our fears about our fantasies. Understand? Whenever your mind involves, your fears become fantasies and fantasies become fears. These are the statements you need to meditate very deeply. When there is an obsessive compulsive behavior, your fantasies become fears and fears become fantasies. Romance become perversion, perversions become romance. War becomes love, love becomes war. Listen carefully. At one point in my life, I reached externally in the outer world, any situation, if I am going to be alive, remembering I exist, it's a blessing. Nothing more can be taken away from me. And internally, if I am still able to consciously cognize I am existing without a mental breakdown, that itself is a blessing. There is nothing more. I don't expect any bliss, or I am not afraid of depression anymore, or the worst mental states, mood swings, or the worst external conditions. See, the fear of the worst possible external conditions and internal conditions have been accepted by the deepest core of my existence, and nothing more to visualize, fantasize about the worst possible external conditions or internal conditions and get frightened. There is nothing more I need to visualize and get frightened. It's all over. That moment, something broke in me. My consciousness touched time, and Yama gave way, Kala gave way, and I reached Kala Kala, Kala Bhairava. Listen. Consciously sitting and cherishing all your fears, not mentally being kicked, just mind releases all the fears and the fears erupt out in you. No, I am not talking about that. I am talking about consciously sitting and visualizing, cherishing. What more can happen where this kind of illogical patterns come? Listen, the modern day politics, corporates, exploited science is the most unscientific. The science manipulated by corporates, chronic capitalists, manipulated by politicians for their political gain is the most unscientific science. Same way, the scientists in the name of science use such absurd logic, systems, methodologies and exploit the mass. I tell you, the most dangerous modern day cult is exploited science, manipulated science. Science exploited by politicians and manipulated by chronic capitalists is the most dangerous modern day cult. Same way, your fears exploited by your mind is the most dangerous threat for your existence. I tell you, I am defining delusion. Oh God, too many things I am revealing. See, I am Paramashiva. I am telling you very simply. You are Paramashiva. Listen carefully. I am Paramashiva. I am telling you very clearly. You are Paramashiva. You just have to start manifesting consciously. Assert your Paramashivatva. Now, when you come back and tell me, no, no, no. See, one gang starts laughing at me. The other gang, no, 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 no. It is all difficult. I know you told me many times, but I have not tried. And there will be one gang. You know, I know you told me I tried. I even manifested 2-3 powers. Then I start getting bored and... Oh, you see, I moved only 3 inch the water bottle. I thought I should move it till my wife's bedroom or my... So, I got a little tired, bored and left. When you come back with unexpected responses, the unexpected, perverted, manipulated responses for the pure, simple initiation is called delusion. When I say you are Paramashiva, you understand the simple, straightforward conversation very sweetly and say yes. When Swamiji is in the human body and he can assert his Paramashivatva, then I am also in the same kind of a human body. I can assert my Paramashivatva and he loves me. He will tell me only what is good for me. Let me do what he is telling. That's it. This simple relationship leads to enlightenment. This is Shaktipada, Shaktinipada. When there is unexpected, unwarranted response from you, that is called delusion. It can be arrogance, abusive, fraudulent, pious fraudulent, it can be any. I wanted to put this on record. There was one Swami whom I respect very much. He has built a beautiful temple. in front of the deity, not even on the deity, below the deity, Peetam, he was sitting, and his disciples have offered aarti for him also along with the deity. Putting this photograph, the anti-Hindus using this photograph and abusing that Swami, is, we can't attend to that, we can't answer them. Hindus, some of my disciples have disrespected that Swamiji for that action, and some of the practicing Hindus have disrespected that Swamiji for that action. I want to put this on record. All my disciples, you will not disrespect that Swamiji for that action, and if you have disrespected, you will complete and apologize. First thing, only I know. First, that goddess, that deity, she manifested in that Swamiji's body. Through that body only, she even built temple for herself. So, what he did is absolutely right and as per Agama. He sat not on the deity, on the peetam of that, means at the feet of the deity, he sat. He sat only at the feet of the deity. And his devotees have done aarti. That is perfectly all right. I tell you, Paramashiva is more present in the consciousness which is ready to manifest him than in any deity. So, understand the principle, cosmic truth, listen carefully. Swadhisthana, fear-centric chakra. If you decide to get involved consciously in your fears, there will be one point you will reach God. Nothing more worse can happen to my existence externally or internally. There can't be any more pain, possible collapse for my external existence or internal existence. You will reach that and drop. That is the moment. The beautiful, powerful cognition will raise in you. From now, every second I am alive internally and I feel I am alive externally itself is a blessing. Nothing more is needed. I neither need bliss, joy inside me to be blissful, to feel fulfilled, nor I need something externally to feel fulfilled and complete. That experience will happen in you if you consciously involve with all your fears, fear fantasies, the patterns, the way the fear manifests in you. Understand? Just like when politicians manipulate science, that becomes the most unscientific. When chronic capitalists manipulate science, not only that becomes most unscientific, most dangerous weapon, cult, to exploit human beings. When your own mind, due to its obsessive compulsive behavior, gets involved into your fears and deludes yourself, whatever you build around you for your security is the worst, most unscientific dangers you do to yourself. Whatever you consider as security you land in putting yourself in danger because of delusion, what do you think as security? Actually, the things which is danger for you, you start thinking them as security. Listen, obsessive compulsive behavior with the sex or fear leads to such delusions. You start enjoying the pains, start building dangerous things around you in the name of security. I tell you, the most dangerous thing you can build in your life for you is continuous self-conflicting, self-criticizing, self-sabotaging thought current. Means, you start cherishing your own failures and see, you need this. You have to get this. You will be getting this only. Self-sabotaging, and then you feel very strongly, anyhow you are going to fail. Why to fail later on? Let's fail now. I tell you, life means you feeling, anyhow I am going to be successful. Why to do after 10 years? Let me become successful now. That is life. This is what Arunagiri Yogeshwara told me. Hey, any one day you have to master all the scriptures and start teaching. Let's do it now, instead of wasting time. I said, yes, Swamiji. If I have to do, why to wait till 30, 40? Let me do it now. This is what is life. But your delusion, sometimes, oh, if I am going to fail, then why wait till the age of 40, 50 to fail? Let's fail now. The other day I was telling one of my sannyasini, she said, anyhow, one day I'll feel hurt and leaving you. Why wait till then? Let me now itself better to leave instead of getting hurt later. Let me get hurt now and leave. I said, this is what exactly delusion, suicidal, life negative. What you call as security is the danger. You build all the dangers. You build an atomic bomb around you and you call that is your security for you. Before it kills others, it will kill you. I'll tell you what is the most secured. Anyhow, one day I have to be successful. So let me become successful now. The right attitude for all of you, listen, anyhow one day I have to reach Kailasa and be with Swamiji. Let me do it as early as possible. That's all. Whether you come and be in Kailasa with me now or next Janma, you have to do. That is where your life ends. Your life concludes. Your climax is reaching Kailasa, Salokya Mukti. Samibhya Mukti, Sarubhya Mukti, Sayujya Mukti, anyhow one day you have to do. Better do it now. This is what is life. And what she told me is the death means life negative. The logic she gave, anyhow one day I'll get hurt and leave. Better to leave now. Get hurt now itself and leave. That is what is absolute suicidal, life negative. No. Anyhow, one day everyone has to come and be in Kailasa. Reach me. Whether you reach me with this body you are carrying and enjoy life around me, or You are going to get new body and come back, all that. But anyhow, one day you have to reach Kailasa, be in Salokya Mukti, Samibya Mukti, Sarubya Mukti, Sayujya Mukti. So better to do now. Exactly. Arunagiri Yogeshwara taught me life. Actually, there was a huge volume book, Vedanta Manana Sindamani. That book name is still like I can remember. Huge, like a pillow, that size of the book. And my grandfather brought that book to me and then said that the class for you is going to start on this subject. On Vedanta Manana means internalizing the powerful cognition. Seeing that book itself, I got frightened. But I know the technique. If I take it to Arunagiri Yogeshwara, I will just chew the whole thing and just directly insert it on my system. Very sweetly you will insert. You will just chew on bit leaf. Literally, you will chew in the mouth and give me the tambulam. I'll just take his hand and take it from his hand. Will not leave even one small bit in his fingers. Literally bite his fingers also and take the tambulam, and the whole knowledge he wants to reveal will be there inside me like experience. So I thought, let me do simple process, like a literally downloading. I took that book and gave it to Arunagiri Yogeshwara and said, my tata told me that I have to start reading this book and they are going to start the class. Then the discussion turned. Arunagiri Yogeshwara started asking me, why are you feeling so tired and bored to read this book? I said, oh God, such big book. Anyhow, I will not be able to complete. Then why to waste time on starting it? He said, fool. That is what is absolute wrong. He told, anyhow, one day you have to finish studying all these scriptures and start teaching to the world. You want to do it when you are 40, 50, or when you want to do it now? Why waste time till 40, 50? I said, that is right. If I have to do any one day, let me do it now. That is what is life. The principle of life. So understand, any one day, anyhow, you have to one day manifest Paramashiva. Better to do it now. If you think, oh, even if I start, one day I'm going to drop it, then why to start? That is what is suicidal. I can rest only after I achieve Sayujya Mukti once for all. Oneness with Paramashiva. Till then I can't rest. I can be moving here, there. Finally, I have to come only there to Paramashivatva. Then why waste time moving here and there? Let me achieve it. That is what is life positive. Listen to this. The moment that clicked with me, with Arunagiri Yogeshwara, I just took the book and said, Swamiji, you bless me that I'll master this book. He just smiled. And this time, usually he will tell me, hey, go and bring white betel leaf. Vella vettala in Tamil. See, he had his own reasons. For some time he will ask me to get the black betel leaf, karuppu vettala. It will not be like a complete black. It is a little blackish on the green leaf. Sometimes he will tell, get vella vettala, white betel leaf, and it will not be like a fully white, it will be little white shade in the green. So this time he neither told me to get the bit leaf, nothing. He just took something from his teeth. I saw it's a sugar candy. And put it in the mouth, in my mouth. And I just saw that whole knowledge of that book, Vedanta Manana Chintamani, has just got into my system. Listen carefully. One day you have to achieve enlightenment. When you are sure about it, you yourself will decide, better let me achieve it now. Why waste time? Next, listen to the next point. Your Manipuraga, navel chakra, is capable of living without external food just by you consciously eating. Please listen. When I am uttering this word, I am responsibly talking. And I know this satsang is getting video recorded, and for the, I don't know how many thousands of years, the generations which is going to come is going to listen to this satsang and practice it sincerely. With that sincere commitment to my Guru Paramashiva and to my disciples who are going to come forever, to this whole Guru Parampara, with that sincerity and commitment and integrity, I am making this statement. Consciously sit and intensely visualize you eating, digesting, getting empowered, building your body for a few days. You will see suddenly, drastically, the need for the physical food will drop. It will drop so much, you will understand the truth behind my statement. Your conscious visualization is enough, whether to liberate you from the sexual needs physically or any other security needs related to fears or any other prana, energy source needs from external world. All the three you can be liberated just by your conscious involvement with your sex, with your fears, with your food. When this three is handled, worries will simply disappear. Worries don't have existence independently other than this three. Source of energy for your system will be absolutely attended by consciously visualizing you eating feast. I am telling you with tremendous responsibility. You try to practice this and see, then you will understand. Within 1 week, 90% of your food intake will drastically drop. If you just practice for 1 week, sit for half an hour every day, visualize as if you are eating too much all kinds of food you want to eat. Just sit and visualize consciously. See, if you are tempted and you get that food and start eating, then you are doing it mentally. That is like a obsessive compulsion. Your marriage, your insurance, your permanent restaurants, all the three are obsessive compulsion. I have a lot of jokes and stories. I will not get into that now. worst delusion, the deluded sense of security is given to you by the name of insurance. You think when the moment you get the life insurance, you are not going to die. The money is going to go to people who are waiting for your death. May even quicken the process as much as possible, as much as legally allowed. And you think that is your security. And marriage is the worst killer of lust. I will not expand on these statements much. All obsessive compulsive involvement with your sex or fear or food leads to more and more life negative, deluded, most unscientific way of existing. Consciously involved. See, just like if you have the habit of decorating deities, doing puja, how micro detail you need to get involved. To that micro detail, sit and visualize consciously, like how Pusalar Nayanar built the temple consciously in his inner space. Like that, sit and visualize all your food related fantasies, all your fear related patterns and unconscious, frightening, terrorizing visualization, which collapses you, which makes you have a mental breakdown or nervous breakdown. Sometimes people think, I can tolerate anything but not the disease. Sometimes people think, I can tolerate anything. See, some people can tolerate anything but can't tolerate certain disease. Some people can tolerate anything but can't tolerate their near and dear one's death. Some people can tolerate anything but can't tolerate losing their freedom, independence, like an imprisonment, fear of prison. Some people can tolerate anything but can't tolerate, handle losing the wealth. Like this, you may have some of the worst terrorizing fears which brings immediately mental breakdown, nervous breakdown. Consciously involve into that fear, visualize them, and what can be done? See how that manipulative patterns of your fears design and show the life, even though you don't have any problem, as filled with problems. I tell you, a Swadhisthana without fear will be absolutely in Turiya. You will never have any dream. Dreamless Turiya state is the symptom. That is the proof your Swadhisthana is absolutely relaxed, pure. Your fears have left you. Understand? Consciously involving with your lust, sex, fantasies, perversions without physical act. Consciously involving with your fear, mental breaking, nervous breaking patterns. The patterns which literally brings mental breakdown, nervous breakdown in you. Consciously involve and go through those patterns, visualization. Let them lose power over you. And consciously sit and eat fill your body and make yourself energetic through that food. If you just do these three consciously, everything you consciously visualize will become reality in the world. Listen, I don't have time to waste with the fools who don't feel connected that I am Paramashiva. If you feel connected to my identity, the principle Paramashiva, which I am manifesting, then my life is for you. If you don't feel connected, switch off the TV and go and see what you like. Go and spend time in what you like. And go and at least enjoy your life as per your definition of enjoyment. If you are here feeling connected to my declaration that I am representing, manifesting the greatest principle of the cosmos, Paramashiva, listen to what I am saying. Just this three visualization consciously, start playing with them. You can choose one day. One day you can choose fear, one day you can choose lust, one day you can choose food. All I am asking is half an hour from you. Play with them for next 1 week. One day sit and visualize all the food variety you want to eat. You are eating and becoming energetic with that food. One day sit and get into the depths of the fears which brings mental breakdown, nervous breakdown literally inside you. Consciously get to the depth of it. It will be literally like a cobweb removed from your brain. Oh God, such a simple thing. Life is so simple. Why did I complicate it so much? You will feel that relief. The cobweb removed from your brain is the dream states removed from your consciousness. All delusion will go. If you feel my eyes are very sharp and you want that kind of a sharp eyes, this is the method. Sit. If you enjoy my eyes and you like my eyes the way it is sharp and you want the depth which is there in my eyes, in your eyes, stop dreaming. The technique for stopping the dreaming is sit and get into the nervous breaking, mental breaking fears of your life and how that cobweb pattern is created in your brain and how you are deluded and caught into that cobweb and how that pattern triggers and puts you in mental breakdown and makes you feel nervous breakdown and insecurity. In that insecurity, you do all stupid things and destroy your life. Get out of it. I am giving you the boon today. With the blessings of Kalabhairava, practice this truth which I am revealing. All will be liberated from fears. As Kalabhairava, I bless you all. All of you will be free from all fears. Practice, manifest this simple truth. All the Paramashivoham season 14 participants, I bless you all. Listen. If you want the sharpness in my eyes, light, tejas in my eyes, do this process. Get into the patterns of fears which brings mental breakdown, nervous breakdown in you. Face them, you will be free. You will have that sharp eyes. First, second, any of you want this flat tummy? If you feel I really want that flat tummy, sit and visualize intensely, consciously eating all the food you ever want to eat. Without eating, mentally, consciously, not mentally, listen to this statement, not mentally, but consciously eat. Mentally, if you start eating dosa, you will try to get dosa and eat. Mentally, if you start thinking of pizza, you will try to get pizza and eat. That is obsessive compulsive behavior. No. Consciously sit and visualize you are eating and feeling energized by that food. Suddenly, you will see 90% of your food need intake will drop within a week. You will have this flat belly, flat stomach. Third, if you want this shining skin, if you feel suddenly I become too shining and you want that, sit without going through the sexual physical act, intensely go through the visual conscious act of all the fantasies you ever collected, romance or perversion, anything. You will see the whole consciousness becomes complete, pure, petals and shining. This tree is the science of Kayakalpa. Science of Kayakalpa. I do not have any fantasy of romance or perversion with this world. My fantasy is black holes and big bangs manifesting. Explosion of billions of black holes, big bangs, Brahmanda yoni manifesting. This cosmos, I have no fantasy related to this world. This world's romance or perversion neither reaches me nor touches me. The cosmos manifests consciously through this being. Listen to this satsang 2-3 times. Try to take notes of each truth I revealed. try to have vakyartha sadas. Try to do just these three things for next 1 week. You will simply start manifesting state, space, powers, being, super consciousness and kailasa of Paramashiva. With this, I bless you all. Let's all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Shuddhatvaita Saivam. The state, space, powers, being, super consciousness and kailasa of Paramashiva. Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. The eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.
श्री कैलासोन्नत द्वादशांत श्यामला पीठारूढ़ श्री मीनाक्षि सुंदरेश्वरा भिन्न स्वरूप परशिव पुत्र रत्न कुमार गुरुमण्य तुल्यावतार श्री पार्वती स्तन्यपान लब्ध दिव्य ज्ञान विश्रुत सकल निगमागम सार भूत द्राविड वेद प्रवक्त्रे श्रीमत् परम शिव करुणा समधिगत मुक्तामय चतुरश्रयान गीयमान छत्र चामर श्री चिन्ह काहलादि समस्त बिरदावल्य अलंकृत ज्ञान विज्ञान चक्रवर्ती सर्वजन संघ सद्यो निर्वाण दीक्षा व्ययापवर्ग वर्ष विश्राण जीमूत परमत कलभ केसरी शैव सिद्धांत स्थापनाचार्य श्रीराजाधिराज पांड्य महाराज गुरु क्षपण शाक्यादि महांधकार निवारण ज्ञान भानु वीक्षणानर्हार्हध्वजोच्छेदन पूर्वक श्रीमद्वृषभध्वजस्थापक शैव समयकर्त्रे सर्वज्ञपीठारूढ श्रीजगद्गुरु श्रीज्ञानसम्बन्धदेशिकस्वामि वागीशसुन्दरमाणिक्यवाचकस्वामिनाम् अवतारभूत श्री ज्ञान संबंध स्वामी पुनरुद्धृत श्यामला पीठ सर्वज्ञ पीठ त्रिनवत्युत्तर द्विशत तम गुरु महासन्निधान अरुणगिरि योगीश्वर परंपरागत अरुणाचल सर्वज्ञ पीठ गुरु महासन्निधान कैलास परंपरागत कांची कैलास सर्वज्ञ पीठ त्रयस्त्रिंशदुत्तर द्विशत तम गुरु महासन्निधान नित्योत्सव नित्यमंगल नित्यकल्याण नित्यरजित कैलास परंपरागत आदि कैलास नित्यानंद पीठ महासंस्थान महासिंहासन पीठ कर्ता साक्षात् श्री परम शिव समुद्भूत कैलास परंपरागत वैवस्वत मनु इक्ष्वाकु हरिश्चंद्र भगीरथ श्रीरामचंद्र शूरसेन इत्यादि अनवच्छिन्न सार्वभौम चक्रवर्ती परंपरागत चतुष्षष्टि योगिनी मंडित चतुष्षष्टि संप्रदाय प्रवर्तक मनुधर्म शासन सूर्यवंश प्राप्त सर्वज्ञपीठ सुरांगी साम्राज्य मूर्धाभिषिक्त चूड़ामणे साक्षात् श्री परम शिव समुद्भूत कपिल महागुरु पुनरुद्धृत महानिर्वाणी पीठ अष्टोत्तर सहस्र श्री महामंडलेश्वर साक्षात् श्री परम शिव सिंहासनाभिषिक्त समस्त गणनायक श्री महागणपति समारंभ अनवच्छिन्न पीठाधीश्वर गुरु परंपरा प्राप्त अटल पीठ अष्टोत्तर सहस्रतम अष्टोत्तर सहस्र श्री अटल पीठाधीश्वर धर्म मुक्ति स्वर्ग पुरस्वर्ण पीठ त्रयोविंश गुरु महासन्निधान कैलास परंपरागत आदिपीठ सर्वज्ञ पीठ जगद्गुरो श्री कैलास पुनरुद्धारक श्री कैलास परमाचार्य श्रीमत् परमहंस परिव्राजकाचार्य वर्य सच्चिदानंद प्रणव स्वरूप श्रोत्रिय ब्रह्म निष्ठ श्रीमज्जगद्गुरु श्रीलश्री भगवत्श्री नित्यानंद परम शिव श्री ज्ञान संबंध देशिक परमाचार्य स्वामिन् अत्रागत्य परिपाल्य च अस्मान् विज्ञान वितरणेन विजयी भव विजयी भव जय जय।
Blissful. You all, let you all open all your three eyes and manifest the powers of Mahasadashiva.
Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Shivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम्
शिवोऽहम् ॐ నిత్యం ధ్యానం ఆనందం నిత్యానందం ఆనందం నిత్యానందం ఆనందం నిత్యం ధ్యానం ఆనందం నిత్యం ధ్యానం ఆనందం
నిత్యం ధ్యానం ఆనందం
ஞானம் ஆனந்தம் நித்யானந்தம் ஆனந்தம் நித்யானந்தம் ஆனந்தம்.